As the after completion of the general characters of the Reptilia, so today we are discussing the detailed information about the characteristic features of the Reptilia. The detailed information about the characteristic feature, the characters of the reptiles, and what is the embryonic membrane, how many classes they are classified. What is that? Important classification, the important characteristic feature, important general characters. Important general characters. So first one, the head of the what is that? The head of the reptiles are the craniata. So the head ends with one of the opening that is called is the temporal lobe. Are you clear? Like this. So one of the head, cranium. The cranium containing one of the last opening. The opening is known as the temporal lobe. But the head containing what are the four lobes are there? How many lobes? There four lobes are there. Four lobes are there. First one is the last one is known as a temporal lobe. Temporal lobe. Third one is occipital lobe. Temporal lobe and occipital lobe. So the temporal lobe, this one is known as a parietal lobe. This is known as a frontal lobe. Completely the head, the cranium can be distinguished into four regions. First one is known as a frontal lobe. This one is known as a frontal lobe. Frontal lobe. This one is known as a parietal lobe. Parietal lobe. This one is known as a occipital lobe. This one is known as a temporal lobe. Like this one. This one is known as a temporal lobe. So the temporal lobe, what is that? Is one of the special characters of the vertebrate. It is containing one of the temporal lobe. Temporal lobe is nothing but the behind of the cranium. It is one of the opening. The opening is completely extends into the opening completely extends extension of the brain. The opening is in this opening the brain is completely extends. So the extension of the brain is called as a spinal cord. The extension of the brain is called as a spinal cord. Nothing but there is containing extension of the brain. The extension of the brain is called as spinal cord. Nothing but these are containing temporal bone is present in the cranium. The cranium containing temporal lobe. The temporal lobe is present in reptiles. Very important. First character. So these amphibians are the absence of the temporal lobe. So what is the character? What is the special character? It is a gradually development of their characteristic features of the reptiles. Is one of the class. So the amphibians are lacking of the temporal lobe, but the reptiles are presence of the temporal lobe, nothing but the gradually changing of their cranial system. Clear? One thing. Next one, the either side of the cranium containing the what is that fossae present. Which one? The either side of the cranium containing what are this one is known as a fossae. The either side of the cranium containing fossae are present. Very important. The special characters and very important characters of the Reptilia. Like this. These are completely containing. What are the fossae are present? The cranial present. Cranium containing. Contains fossae. So these fossae are located in the temporal region. So that is called as a temporal fossae. So this is a body of extension. So the temporal region, the fossae are located in the temporal region, either sides of the temporia. So this is called as a temporal fossae. Like this, temporal fossae, nothing but this one is temporal fossae. And above the eye, this one is all temporal. Everyone, touch here. Touch on your and surface of the eye. This one is known as a temporal fossa. So one of the special character. And next one. Teeth. The teeth are monophyodont, heterodont, and polypyodont. Monodont means similar teeth are there. heterodonts means different teeth are there. Polyphyodonts means number of the different type of teeth. Monophyodont teeth, monodont. And you can write only polyphyodont. Polyphyodont, monodont and polyphyodont teeth are present on two jaws. Clear. And the next one, the special character. So the reptiles are consistent of the three chambered heart, exception of the crocodile. Very important character, exception of the crocodile. So the important characters are, we are writing in this way, exception of crocodiles, the remaining all reptiles. Very important, remaining all reptile contain how many? Three chamber. Reptiles are remaining all are contains how many? Three chambered heart. The remaining three all containing three chambered heart. Clear. The crocodile containing four chambered heart. Clear. So in the reproduction, the amphibian, just recapitulate once. The amphibians are, what is the stimulation of the female? The females are releasing of the more number of the eggs into what is the aquatic region, as well as the male also releasing of the more number of the sperm. The sperm and what is ovum are both are together to form a subzygote. Clear. Okay, the fertilization takes place in the outside of the body, that is clear. There is no involvement of the any capillary organ. Only the alpaxary pillows are attachment of the female body. The female is stimulated, the female is releasing of the more number of the ovums. As well as the male is all releasing. But there is no involvement, there is no penetration was occur. But in this reptile, the development process is occur. So in this reptiles, so their development of the muscular penetrative organ. The development of, in the reproduction, very important. The development of the muscular penetrative organ is present in male individuals. Okay, the muscular penetrative organs are present in the male individual. So this muscular penetrative organs are directly fused into the female body and releasing of the sperms and take fertilization inside. So that is known as the internal fertilization takes place. Internal fertilization, like this. Both are combined together to formation of zygote. Internal fertilization. Okay, very very important character is the muscular penetrative organ is formed, presence in reptiles. Are you clear? What I am saying, another one, these are internal fertilization, as well as these are oviparous. These are oviparous organism and as well as viviparous. I will give the example, viviparous and oviparous. I will give the best examples of these two one. Oviparous individuals are laying of the eggs, nothing but releasing of the laying eggs, like tortoise, snakes. So these individuals are releasing more number of the eggs in the outside of the body, that is known as the oviparous laying eggs. Clear. Second one, viviparous, releasing of the offspring. I will give the example also. Release offspring, direct offspring. I will give the example. Examples of the snakes and tortoise, lizard, golden lizard, and etc. Snakes, what is the crocodiles, tortoise, and etc. We know that, yes. A lizard, garden lizard, we can add also. Lizard and garden lizard, and etc. Next one, the releasing of the offspring. Which individuals are releasing of the offspring? Most number of the marine snakes, only marine snakes, nothing but the bungarus. I'm very, very sorry. The most number of the what is that? OC, nothing but marine snakes. Example, rat snakes. Most number of the marine snakes. Marine snakes are releasing of direct offspring. Direct offspring. The fertilization takes place internal side, inner side. The releasing of direct offspring, there is no releasing of the eggs. Is one of the character. Clear. Excretion through the metanephridia like a kidney. Yes, we know that. So the body of the organisms are completely covered by the outermost covering. Hard rigid surface is there. So the most number of the organism like crocodiles are containing internal hidden scales are present. Internal hidden scales. The ectoderm containing internal hidden scales are present. Internal hidden scales are present. We see the what is that crocodiles. The crocodiles are containing more number of the scales. Okay, the hidden scales are present. The skin is rough and rigid. Skin is rough and rigid in nature, nothing but hard. Rough and rigid in nature. We know that. Clear. Excretion, very, very important. The excretion is all of the organisms are uricotelic. Excretion. Example, excretion is uricotelic. Uricotelic organisms. Excretion through the urea, that is called organisms are called as uricotelic organisms. Clear? So these are very important characteristic features. And as well as this is the releasing of the eggs. Yes or no? That is called oviferous. Very, very important. They are asking 2 marks question from the oviparous. Listen carefully. What is that? So these are fertilization takes place into the outside of the body. So they are releasing of the eggs. So the development is outside of the body. So the egg, the releasing of egg. So the egg will be converts into new adult one after their hatching. Hatching of the head, these are converts into new adult one. How they are converts into adult one? Which type of layers are there? So what is they are performed?